At a St Albans reception centre...
Stop, please!
..a fight erupts between two groups on either side of the property's fence and either side of a political regime in Africa. From peaceful to violent in a flash. A fence torn down, windows smashed, blood everywhere. 10 people taken to hospital.
Just all running at them, swinging flags, throwing bricks, pretty much anything they could do.
Inside the building, an Eritrean community group. Those outside claim that same group supports a dictatorship in Eritrea.
Was it supposed to turn violent?
No, it wasn't supposed to turn violent.
Senate Habtemariam was one of the protesters outside. Government officials and police met with Eritrean leaders here to avoid violence, but it blew up anyway.
I did not take a weapon with me. None of us took weapons with us. We went there to demonstrate, to call for human rights, so we can't be going there taking weapons.
Eritrea is in eastern Africa, near the Red Sea. There has never been an election. President Afwerki has been in power 30 years.
It's a very corrupt and dictatorial regime, so that's just stifling economic development.
It's considered the North Korea of Africa.
At one of these community meetings in Melbourne last year, children were dressed in military clothing and paraded with guns. The community group didn't respond to our inquiries. There have been similar Eritrean protests in Canada and Israel.
Countries that have taken in the Eritrean refugees over the last 30 years have found those refugees being intimidated by the government back home.
With the broken wall, torn down fences and 8 smashed windows, the owner estimates damage here to be about $40,000. And they're madly cleaning up inside because tonight they have another function for Vietnamese New Year.
The venue was booked just a day in advance. Activists tried to have the event cancelled.
We tried to warn, but the venue didn't want to listen to us, and the people that were conducting the event did it in hiding, and then something happened that we were trying to avoid.
Police have plenty of work ahead in this case. More than 100 people were involved in the violence. The venue has security cameras, but I'm told the hard drive was broken, so much of that violence wasn't captured properly. There have been no charges yet, and of the 10 taken to hospital, 6 are still there tonight. Beck?
Blake Johnson reporting live. Thank you.